Hello students, welcome to AKR chemistry classes. Today I am going to teach a very important topic regarding to class 12, that is solution. In today's class we are going to deal with types of, what is the meaning of solution, then what is that, what are the types of solutions are there, and next we are going to deal with methods of determination of concentration of solution and some problems which are related to the concentration of solution. When salt is added into water, salt do not undergo any reaction with water, but it easily soluble. It easily soluble to form salt solution. I got salt is one component, water is another component. These two components are non-reactive with each other, but salt is easily soluble in water to form salt solution. If I take sugar, when sugar is treated with water, here also sugar do not react with water, or water do not react with sugar, but sugar is easily soluble in water. Sugar is easily soluble in water to form sugar solution. And this type of solutions are also called as homogeneous mixtures. These types of solutions is also called as homogeneous mixture. Now the question arises, what is the actual meaning of homogeneous mixture? It is a mixture of two or more components. Here only two components is there, one sugar, another one is water. In this case one is salt, another one is water, which are uniformly distributed throughout the solution. It is a mixture of two or more components which are uniformly distributed throughout solutions is called as homogeneous mixtures. Then what is the meaning of solutions? Very simple. Solutions are the homogeneous mixtures which contains two or more components. In the above example, I take only two components. One component acts as solute and another component acts as solvent. So solute can exist in three states of matter. Either it may exist in solid state, or it may exist in liquid state, or it may exist in liquid state, or it may exist in gaseous state. Like that also, solvent can also exist in three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. According to our theory, we are studying by taking solid solute and liquid solvent. Solute should be present in solid state. It should be present in solid state, and it is taken in minimum amount. It is mixed with liquid solvent, which is taken in maximum amount to form binary solution. So what is meant by binary solution? It is made up of two components. One is solid solute mixed with liquid solvent. Okay. Now types of solution. As I told you, depend upon the medium of solvent. Solution can broadly classify into three types: gaseous solutions, homogeneous solutions in which the solvent medium is gas, whereas solute may be gas, liquid or solid. Second one is liquid solutions. What are liquid solutions? It is a homogeneous mixture in which solvent medium is liquid. And third one is solid solutions. What are solid solution? Solution in which solvent medium is solid. The solvent medium is solid. So these are the suitable examples. Depend up amount of solute. Amount of solute dissolved in the given solvent, the solution can broadly classified into two types. Solution is broadly classified into three types. The first one is saturated solution. For example, think that 10 grams of sugar. For our convenience, I am writing this example. It is not actually experimentally proved, for our convenience to make you to understand the concept, that's all. Think that 10 grams of sugar exactly soluble in 100 ml of water, completely soluble in 100 ml of water to form sugar solution. So what is the total volume of sugar solution I have got now? 100 ml. So the same sugar solution, if I add 2 more grams of sugar, if I add 2 more grams of sugar, this sugar do not undergo dissociation in this solution. This sugar do not undergo dissociation with this solution. The reason is, this volume of water has an ability to dissolve only 10 grams of sugar. Then such solutions are called as saturated solution. What is meant by saturated solution? Solution which cannot dissolve. Solution which cannot dissolve any further amount of solute added into it. Okay, next coming to unsaturated solutions. Well, I will come back here. I will take exactly 100 ml of water, and we know that in 100 ml of water, how much amount of sugar I can dissolve? 10 grams. But what I will do, I will take only 5 grams of sugar. When 5 grams of sugar is treated with water, we get sugar solution. And the volume of solution considered as 100 ml only. Whether I can dissolve, if I add the same 2 grams of sugar in this solution, whether it is dissolves or not? Yes, it dissolves, because actually 100 ml of water has an ability to dissolve 10 grams. In this case, 100 ml dissolves only 5 grams. Still, this solution has an ability to dissolve 5 more grams of sugar in that 2 grams have been added. Then this solution is called as unsaturated solution. Solution which has ability to dissolve 10 grams of solute added into it. That's all. Then coming to third one, super saturated solutions. So 10 grams of sugar in 100 ml, I will do one thing, 10.2 grams of sugar in 100 ml of solution, 100 ml of water, I got sugar solution. So what is the extra amount present in this 0.2 grams? Whether it is in dissolved state or undissolved state, it is also in dissolved state but not in undissolved state. Then this type of solutions is called as super saturated solution. Solution which contains extra minimum amount of solute which is in dissolved state. At a particular temperature is called as super saturated solutions. Now coming to the next, methods of expressing the strength of the solution. When solute is added into solvent, solvent is purely neutral in nature, it do not have any strength, but whenever the solute is added into water, it get converted into solution. Solutions are more reactive than solvent because solvents are less reactive or least reactive. Solutions are more reactive because solution is made up of two components, one is solute, another in solid. Due to the presence of solute in solvent, solution will get some energy. This energy is expressed in terms of strength of the solution. In that first one is mass percentage. Okay, I will give some example before we understand what is the meaning of mass percentage. Let's take an example, 5% of W by W glucose. What it indicates? 5 grams of glucose present in 100 grams of solution. 5 grams of glucose present in 100 grams of solution. Or I'll take like this, 10% weight by weight urea. 10 grams of urea present in 100 grams of solution. So what here indicates? Number of grams of solute present in 100 grams of solution. Number of grams of solute present in 100 grams, or number of parts by mass of solute per 100 parts by mass of solution, is called as mass percentage. Therefore, mass percentage is always equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 100, since we know that mass of solution is always equal to mass of solute plus mass of solvent. Okay students, pause the video and note it down. Now next one is volume percentage. It is represented as V bar V. 15 V bar V percentage of HCl. What does it indicate? 15 ml of hydrochloric acid present in 100 ml of solution. 25% V bar V alcohol, ethanol, methanol, propanol, whatever it may be. What does it indicate? 25 ml of alcohol present in 100 ml of solution. So it indicates that number of volumes in milliliter, number of volumes of solute in milliliters present in 100 ml of solution, number of volumes of solute in milliliters present in 100 ml of solution, or number of parts by volume of solute per 100 ml of volume of solution, is called as volume percentage. Therefore, it is represented as volume of solute by volume of solution into 100. The next one is mass percentage. Mass volume percentage, W by V. It is represented like this. 15 W by V percent of urea. Nothing but 15 grams of urea present in 100 ml of solution. 25 W by V percentage of glucose. 25 grams of glucose present in 100 ml of solution. So number of parts by mass of solute present in 100 ml of solution, number of parts by mass of solute present in 100 ml of solution, is called as mass volume percentage. Therefore, it is represented as mass of solute
volume of solution into 100 next ppm. Nowadays we are not using this concept anywhere. Parts per million means we are using to determine the hardness of water in terms of ppm. So ppm is represented as mass of solute, number of moles mass of solute present in 10 to the power of 6 parts by mass of solution into 10 to the power of 6. Next, molarity, all these concepts anyhow we taught in the first year PUC concepts called as stoichiometry. Just we are revising here, that's all. Molarity means number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution. Number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution or 1 dm³ of solution, because 1 liter is equal to 1 dm³. 1 liter is equal to 1 dm³. Okay. Since we know that number of moles of solute is always equal to weight of solute by molecular weight of solute. If I represent volume of solution in milliliters, then molarity can be represented as molarity is equal to weight of solute into 1000 by molecular weight of solute into volume of solution in milliliters. Okay, students, note it down. Next one is molality of the solution. Number of moles of solute defined as number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. Number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent is called as molality. Since we know that number of moles of solute is equal to weight of solute by molecular weight of solute. So if mass of solvent is expressed in terms of grams, if mass of solvent is expressed in terms of grams, then molality can be represented as molality is equal to weight of solute into 1000 by molecular weight of solute into mass of solvent in grams. So next one, normality. Number of gram equivalents. Number of gram equivalents of solute. Number of gram equivalents of solute by volume of solution in liter. So since we know that number of equivalents of any solute is equal to weight of that solute by equivalent weight of that solute. Since equivalent weight of solute is always equal to molar mass of solute by its valency. Hence, if volume of solution is expressed in terms of milliliters, then normality can be represented as weight of solute into 1000 divided by equivalent weight of solute into volume of solution in milliliters. Next, coming to relation between molarity and normality. This concept we taught in the first PUC under stoichiometric concept. I will just revise here. Normality of a solution is always equal to molarity into molecular weight of solute by equivalent weight of solute, or it can simply written as normality is n is equal to m into n. Next, coming to mole fraction. Consider reaction with A reacts with B to form products P. Number of moles of A is represented as NA and number of moles of B is represented as NB. Now when it is get converted to product, it will get number of moles of A plus number of moles of B. In the product, I need to find out the ratio of A and B. In the product, we need to find out the moles ratio with respect to A and B. Therefore, we will use a concept called as mole fraction. Therefore, mole fraction of A is equal to number of moles of A by number of moles of A plus number of moles of B, as well as mole fraction of B is equal to number of moles of B by number of moles of A plus number of moles of B. So what is meant by mole fraction? It is the ratio of number of moles of one component to that of number of moles of all the components. Ratio of number of moles of one component by number of moles of all the components is called as mole fraction. Since mole fraction of A and B in a given solution should be always equal to 1. If I know the mole fraction of any one component, second component, I can easily find out. Next, relation between molarity, mass percentage and density of the solution. Density of the solution. Students, in this case, I am not going to give the, or I am not going to teach the derivation regarding with this relation, but I will show you how to write the directly the mathematical equation, because it plays very important role. Plays a very important role in your object level program. So, molarity of solution is always equal to mass percentage, and this mass percentage is W bar W into density of solution in terms of gram per liter into 10 whole divided by molecular weight of solute. So if I know the molecular weight of solute, density and mass percentage, then molarity of the solution can be directly calculated by using this equation. Condition is mass percentage is W bar W. Next, relation between molarity, molality and density of the solution. If I know molarity and density, I can calculate the molality. How? Molality is always equal to 1000 into molarity of the solution divided by 1000 into density of the solution minus molarity into molecular weight of solute. M2 is nothing but molecular weight of solute. If I know molality, then how can I calculate the molarity? Molarity is equal to molality into density divided by 1 plus molality into molecular weight of solute divided by 1000. So like this, I can calculate the molality or molarity by knowing the density of the solution. Relationship between molarity and, sorry, not molarity, sorry, this is not molarity, this is molality. Relationship between molality and mole fraction of the solute. If I know the molality, if molality of solution is known, then I need to calculate the mole fraction. then mole fraction of the solute, mole fraction of solute is equal to molality divided by molality plus 1000 divided by m2. What is sorry, not m2, this is not m2, this is m1. M1, what is the meaning of m1? Molecular weight of solvent. Molecular weight of solvent. If I know mole fraction, then I need to calculate the molality. Therefore, molality is equal to 1000 into mole fraction of solute by mole fraction of solvent into molecular weight of solvent. Is nothing but mole fraction of solute. X1 is nothing but mole fraction of solvent, and M1 is nothing but molar mass or molecular weight of solvent. Please note it down. Next, coming to relation between molarity, normality and volume of the solution. For dilute solution, we know the normality equation. What is the normality equation? N1 V1 is always equal to N2 into V2. Okay, ra? Since normality is always equal to molarity into N factor, or molarity is always equal to normality by N factor. If N1 value is equal to 1, then this one can written as M1 V1 is equal to M2 into V2. Okay, children, until now I have given equation how to express the first what I taught. Until now I taught how to express the concentration of a solution, and I have given the relation between molarity, normality, mass percentage, everything, mole fraction. So based on all this equation, now we will going to solve some problems. Before solving the problems, please go through the equation one more time. I think so you have learned the equation properly, then we will go with the problems. Calculate the mass percentage of benzene and carbon tetrachloride if 22 grams of benzene is dissolved in 122 grams of carbon tetrachloride. First, we need to calculate mass percentage of benzene, W by W, percentage of benzene. C6H6 is always equal to mass of benzene, C6H6 divided by mass of solution, means two components, mass of benzene C6H6 plus mass of CCl4 into 100. Okay, what is the mass of benzene? They given 22 grams divided by 22 plus 122, that is 144 into 100. Your answer will be equal to 15.28%. Next, I need to calculate this one weight percentage of benzene. Now, I need to calculate mass percentage of carbon tetrachloride is equal to 100 minus. Either I can solve by this method or I can solve by one more method. 100 minus mass percentage of benzene, C6H6, that is equal to 100 minus 15.28, that is equal to 100 minus 15.28 is equal to 84.72%. Okay, students, go for next question. Calculate the mole fraction of benzene in solution containing 30% by mass in carbon tetrachloride. So 30% by mass, W bar W, what does it indicates? 30 grams of benzene, C6H6, 30 grams of benzene present in 100 grams of solution. I need to calculate the mole fraction of benzene. We know that mole fraction of benzene, C6H6, is always equal to number of moles of benzene by number of moles of benzene plus number of moles of carbon tetrachloride. Number of moles nothing but mass by molecular mass. So first I need to find out what is the number of moles of benzene. So mass of benzene I know, molecular mass of benzene is 78, therefore number of moles of benzene C6H6 is equal to mass of benzene they are given, that is 30 divided by 78, it is equal to 0.384 mole. We know that mass of solution or mass of solvent is equal to mass of solution minus mass of solute. Mass of solvent means mass of carbon tetrachloride is equal to mass of solution, we know 100 grams, minus mass of solute is 30 grams, that is equal to 70 grams. Therefore, number of moles of carbon tetrachloride is equal to mass by molecular mass. The molecular mass is 154. This is 12 plus 35.5 into 4. You will get this much. That is equal to 0.454 mole. Okay, students, now you try to calculate the remaining part of the problem. I will give you 1 minute. Try to solve it. So what I need to find out, mole fraction of benzene. Therefore, mole fraction of benzene C6H6 is always equal to 0.384 divided by 0.384 plus 0.454. What is the answer? Final answer 0.458. And mole fraction of carbon tetrachloride is equal to 0.541. Is the answer. Going to next question. Calculate the molality, molarity and mole fraction of potassium iodide if the density is, if they are given the density and this one. First I will calculate the molecular weight of potassium iodide. Molecular weight of potassium iodide is equal to 39 plus 127, 166 grams. If they given mass percentage and density, I can calculate first molarity. Molarity is equal to, I know that, mass percentage into density into 10 divided by molecular weight of solute. Mass percentage is 20 into density is 1.202 into 10 divided by 166. Find out the answer how much you got. That is equal to 1.448 molar. The second one I will calculate the molality. If I know molarity and density, I can calculate the molality. How molality is equal to 1000 into M divided by 1000 into D minus molality into molecular weight. This equation already taught. Therefore, 1000 into 1.448 divided by 1000 into density is 1.202 minus 1.448 into 166. So try to solve the problem. We get exactly 1.5 molal. This is capital letter M. This is small letter M. Okay. And last I need to calculate the mole fraction of potassium iodide. Mole fraction of potassium iodide is equal to number of moles of potassium iodide divided by number of moles of potassium iodide plus number of moles of water. 20% mass by mass, nothing but 20 grams of potassium iodide present in 100 grams of solution. So mass of potassium it is 20. Since mass of solution, mass of solvent I need to find out, that is water is equal to mass of solution is 100 minus mass of solvent is 20, that is equal to 80 grams. So mole fraction of potassium iodide, sorry, potassium iodide is equal to number of moles of potassium iodide, 20 divided by 166 whole divided by 20 divided by 166 plus 80 divided by molecular mass of water is 18, which is equal to how much? 0.026. Pause the video and note it down. Next, calculate the mass of urea required to prepare 2.5 kg of solution having this molarity. 2.5 kg of solution, not solvent, 2.5 kg of solution. We know that molality is always equal to mass of urea divided by molecular weight of urea into mass of solvent. Okay, ra? In kgs. Since mass of urea by mass of molecular mass of urea is nothing but number of moles. Therefore, number of moles of urea is equal to mass of urea is W and molecular mass of urea is 60. I need to find out what is the mass of solvent. Mass of solvent is always equal to, in the grams I need to find out. Here I will, mass of solution into, sorry, not into, mass of solvent, no, mass of solution minus mass of solute. Mass of solution is how much? 2.5 kg. Therefore 2.5 into 1000, because I getting in grams, minus mass of solute is W. Therefore it becomes 2500 minus W. Therefore, finally, what I need to find out? Molarity. Molarity, I know 0.25 is equal to mass of urea divided by 60 into 2500 minus W. Hence, mass of urea is equal to 36.94 grams. Note it down. Next question is very simple. Calculate the molarity of 1 liter solution of 93% of sulfuric acid by mass by volume. 93% of mass by volume is of H2SO4, means very simple, 93 grams of sulfuric acid H2SO4 present in 100 ml of solution. But I need to convert into 1 liter, this one into 1 liter. Therefore, I will write it like this. 930 grams of acid present in 1000 ml of solution. Okay. Now, what we need to do, since we know that density is nothing but mass by volume, or I can write it as mass of solution, density they have given as 1.84 gram per cc is equal to mass of solution into density. Sorry. since sorry mass of solution, mass of solution is always equal to density of solution into volume of solution. Density given 1.84 gram per cc into volume of solution is 1000 cc, that is equal to 1840 grams. If I know the volume of solution, I can calculate the volume of mass of solvent. For mass of solvent, here solvent is water. Water is equal to 1840 minus 930 is equal to 910 grams. Mass of solvent is the mass of solution minus mass of solute. Therefore, molarity is equal to weight of solute into 1000 by molecular weight of solute into mass of solvent in grams. Therefore, molarity is equal to weight of solute is 930 into 1000 divided by molecular weight of solute, that is 98 sulfuric acid into 910. How much you get? Almost equal to 10.4 molal. 10.4 molal. Mole fraction of solute in aqueous solution of NaOH is 0.1%. So we can write this one like this. Water and NaOH present together, therefore mole fraction of NaOH plus mole fraction of water is equal to 1. Then what is the mole fraction of NaOH? They given 0.1% and mole fraction of water will be 0.9%. Since we know that mole fraction is always equal to weight by molecular weight of the given substance, weight by molecular weight of the given substance. So if I know the molecular weight, mole fraction, I can calculate the mass. Therefore, weight of sodium hydroxide, mass of sodium hydroxide is equal to mole fraction of sodium hydroxide into molecular weight, 0.1 into 40, that is equal to 4 grams. Okay, next one. Mass of water. Therefore, mass of water is equal to mole fraction of H2O into its molecular weight. Mole fraction of water is 0.9 into 18, that is equal to 16.2 grams. Therefore, what is the meaning of molality? Molality is equal to weight of solute. What is the weight of solute? 4 into 1000. What is the molecular weight of solute? That is sodium hydroxide, 40 into. What is the mass of solvent? We got 16.2, which is equal to how much? 6.172 molal. We know that molality is equal to weight of solute into 1000 by molecular weight of solute into mass of solvent in grams. Okay, students, I have written this one here. Read out the next question. Calculate the molality of 10% of weight by volume of NaOH solution having the density 1.10 gram. So 10% weight by volume of NaOH is nothing but 10 grams of sodium hydroxide present in 100 ml of solution. So if I want to calculate the molality, I need to calculate mass of solute, that is 100 grams, and mass of the solvent. Density also they given. Therefore, mass of solution is always equal to its density of solution into volume of solution, that is equal to density 1.10 into, what is the volume? 100, that is equal to 110 grams. Okay, right? Therefore, mass of solvent is equal to mass of solution minus mass of solute. mass of solution is 110 grams minus mass of solute is how much? 10. This is solute, no? That is equal to 100 grams. Therefore, molality is equal to weight of solute into 1000 by molecular weight of solute into mass of solvent. Weight of sodium hydroxide is to 10 into 1000 divided by 40 into 100. 10 tensa. So finally you will get 100 divided by 40, 2.5 molal. Okay, next question. Calculate the molality of an aqueous solution of a compound whose mole fraction of the solute is 0.2. Whose mole fraction of the solute is 0.2. Solve it. So how to solve the problem? Mole fraction of solute is always equal to 1 minus I will take solvent. This one as solvent is equal to 1 minus mole fraction of solute. Okay, that is equal to 1 minus 0.2, that is equal to 0.8. What does it mean? 0.2 moles of solute. It indicates that 0.2 moles of solute present in 0.8 moles of solvent. Therefore, mass of solvent is equal to number of moles into molecular weight of water. Number of moles is 0.8 into 18. That is equal to how much you get? 0.8 into 18. You will get 14.4 grams. Therefore, molality M is always equal to 0.2 into 1000 divided by 0.8 into 18, that is 14.4, which is almost equal to 14. Almost equal to 14. Or we can also use one concept I taught you how to find this one. If I know the mole fraction, how to calculate the molality? Molality is equal to mole fraction of solute into 1000 divided by mole fraction of solvent into molecular weight of solvent. This equation already given, so that you can solve very easily. What is this value? 0.2 into 1000 divided by 0.8 into 18. Here also you are getting same, almost equal to 14. Okay students, this completes today's topic. Thank you for watching the videos. If you like this, please subscribe for more videos for AKR channel. Thank you and have a nice day.